Look at what credit card companies are about to do. I hope you like paying an extra $700 a year. Cue the fire in your monthly, well, that'd be your yearly bill. Mastercard, poof, sees profits through the roof. You guys are just, oh my gosh, everything is great. We have to put everything on the credit card. Maybe everything's not so great. And when I say not so great, did you happen to see that thing called gross domestic product, GDP? It's kind of gross. U.S. economy posts surprise contraction. And so just in case you're thinking, you know what? I think I'm going to go all in. Let me give you a little warning sign here. That's your warning sign. Please don't. And also, please stop listening to people and their fundamentals. Good old Kathy Wood. And if you woke up this morning with a wood, it probably won't be. I mean, this girl cannot catch a break. It's like everything she had a good year. All right. A couple years ago, it was pretty good. But I think Kathy is now the poster child of the 2.0.com, whatever this is. Collapse or whatever you want to call it. Cue the fire. We see MasterCard. Well, they see this. They're like, wow, this is great. See, spending soar. Huh. Where are you guys getting all that money from? Okay, you're done with the stimmies, so it must be going on the credit card. And MasterCard's like, well, what are you guys talking about? Inflation? There's no inflation. Hasn't started hurting our results. Oh, no, but it will. And just in case you wanted to know how much you put on the card, I can tell you, 22%. My wife did probably most of all of that. I mean, if you were to take her spending out of MasterCard's and Visa's equation, their profits would probably be down. And just so I'm accurate on the numbers, the card jumped 22%, so 1.52 trillion. Okay, my wife only put 1.5 trillion on the card this year. And half of it, she did it overseas. Oh, hey, look. They even have her overseas spending climb 53%. That would be me. And just to reinforce this, MasterCard's first quarter profits jump as she's talking. As cross-border travel.
I hope you like your hand tonight.
Wasn't even talking about you. I mean, she just left. She never watches my videos. But then she can hear me, and I'm like, okay, so maybe I should just whisper when I talk about my wife. And I don't know what she's talking about. I hope I like my hand tonight. It has, why is there hair growing on my hand? And okay, I Googled it, hair to grow on palm. I don't know, should I braid this? When an innocent young man, okay, it has nothing to do with me. And actually, I'd probably say that that is false, that is incorrect statements, but you can go blind, okay? Kids, I'm telling you, you probably want to just do it until you have to wear glasses. Your no annual fee credit card, because this is what you wanted to know. You're like, did you just say I'm going to have to pay $700? Coming to you from Quartz, costing you $700 a year, U.S. retailers say. And it has a lot to do with this right here. See this? This surcharge of 50 cents, which just to let you know, if you snitch on them, they can't do that. They can't go like, okay, we're going to charge you. Yes, no, they signed an agreement with Visa and MasterCard that they cannot to charge you for that. But what they do is they put it in the back end, and you never want anything put in the back end. But I am not here to judge. You do you. Most credit card companies don't impose swipe fees on what? On you, on customers or consumers, charging vendors instead. But shoppers end up bearing these costs. Yes, you will, as vendors hike the price to cover the fees so you can't see it. But that is going to cost you $700 a year. But the good news is you have the politicians on your side. Congress members last week called on Visa and MasterCard to stop the hikes, which would net the companies another $1.2 billion. And our members of Congress said your profits are already high enough. Why would you do this? And I would probably say I wouldn't be worried about the $1 billion Congress. I would be worried about the trillions of dollars or the quadrillions of dollars in the derivatives market.
Because when that thing blows, $1 billion is going to be like a fart in the wind
or in orbit. I mean, you wouldn't even smell it. It'd be way too far away.
Oh, and just in case you missed it, our lovely GDP, this is bad, okay? When the lines look like that, that means we ain't doing nothing. That's also the time that they locked us all down in our houses, and they said, it's okay, it's just going to be like 2 weeks. It's all right, this thing will pass. But then they unlocked you, and they gave you lots of stimmies. And so you can actually manipulate this GDP by giving the people money. Crazy, right? But what you want to see is green, okay, just natural green. What you don't want to see is me trying to move this thing. I'm struggling here. There, that is where we are currently out without the stimmies. So I say, raise your taxes, give people stimmies and make them. No, I would never say that. No, what I would say is like, how do I swing trade that? Or how can I know ahead of time that it's going to look like that and then make money from it? Well, I'm glad you asked. So let me just start off with this, a photo. First things first, do not drink adult beverages, alcoholic beverages when trading. Also, number two, do not listen to the fundamentals, right? Kathy Wood just... We're going long on all of this stuff. And I guess when it doesn't work, head over to the Bahamas. I don't know. That probably would work. I mean, how much is ARK down based on fundamentals? We got to focus on fundamentals. This is what fundamentals gets you, kids, in a, I call it a beauty pageant. Currently down 70%. And just so I don't get any emails, I will measure perfectly from the top. To the bottom of the wick, 71%. Yeah, that looks worser. But then the question you may ask, well, how would you know, Bravo? How do you know that that's going to, well, maybe that's a top, that's a head and shoulders. How about just one thing for you? Let's just turn on one simple little blue line. How about the 200-day moving average? Don't ever swing trade underneath this blue line. You got to wait for that blue line to catch up to that little red line. Don't hold your breath. And here, let me show you. This is Twitter. See? I can't believe it. They're like right there. You're right there, Twitter. Actually, that little thing goes way back. I drew this. See the green lines, the head and shoulders? I'm like, it breaks that little green line. I'm like, sell. If you listened, right? Actually, you wouldn't even be... that would be pretty close to that 200. You swing trade, it goes all the way down to the bottom. But now, just in case you're wondering, never financial advice, only paper trading on this channel. You want to keep climbing that ladder all the way up there, but it's probably going to bang its head right on that 200-day moving average, just like it did there, just like it did there. Let me turn on the 9 count. I probably just guess it's probably too high right now. And lo and behold, looky there, you are at number 9. You will have a pullback, just like you had a pullback here, right? That's what happens. See, the 9 down there is like, no, we're going so far to the moon. Nope, you pull back. So here you go. Let's have a... So this, what I am saying is don't paper trade, go long right now on Twitter. Actually, heading back to Kathy Wood and your fundamentals, this was a big one. Teladoc. How's that one doing there? Well, in case you were waiting on the 9 count, I wouldn't have held your breath. But what do we always do? Exit prior to that little E. Oh, and just in case you're wondering, I do have the 200-day moving average turned on for this company. We just can't seem to find it because it's way the hell up there. And wow, talk about how to lose a lot of money, Kathy. Oh my goodness gracious. From $300 a share to $30. That is a 90%. Oh, gosh, it's so painful. I mean, I could have, if you would have been in the course, you probably could have gotten out at least there. I mean, don't get me wrong, but turning on my buy-sell indicators, you made a whole lot of money on the way up. But what goes up? Look at this. Buy-sell, buy-sell. Right there, right? You're like, eh. Oh, but wait, we're above the 200 again. That was an amazing buy. Wow. And also, for those of you that are in the course, I do not have it set. Hold on. Let me do this. That was about a 32% move. That was a good one. But again, even though the buy sells come on. No,
That's a no.
I did not code it to say once under. Maybe I should. Also, before I... Oh, you subscribe. Did you like? I forgot. I always have to tell you ahead of time because then you like it. The next video. Today is Be a Super National Superhero Day. So learn, because of this one-day sale, National Superhero Day, 75% off how to swing trade. And then you can learn how to do this and be a superhero. Pass it on to your kids. Go teach it in high school like I did. Help people not lose a whole lot of money. That's most of your money. And if you're like, well, you go do that, Bravo, I have my whole life. I've taught this 22 years and probably closer to 25 if you count me being a sub. Not so good. Elementary school. Those parents did not like me nor my... Yeah, you're like, oh my gosh, they allowed you around kids? This way you don't get wrecked. Look, Robinhood investors brace for what? More losses. And I'm telling you, you don't need me or these news stories or these analysts because they're going to predict. You know what they've been predicting? I can go back and they're like all in. I mean, Robinhood, I had the CEO on, kind of. I couldn't air it. I was actually with my daughter who was Robinhood kid at the time. Actually, she's going to be on CNBC or something today or tomorrow. So congratulations to Kayla Kilbride. 2 months? 3 months? How many? We got a Papa Bravo coming in here. I got my first grandkid to screw up. And you know I'm going to. I'm going to be terrible. I'm going to be sending them all. Oh, let's go to Papa Bravo's house. Where he gives us gold, silver, candy, you name it. It just oozes out of this nice guy. My kids are like, I swear he was never that way. How much have you lost on this trade? I would turn on the 200-day moving average, but yeah, 86%, basically all of it. And no, there is no 200-day moving average. Why is that? That is because it was too new. Actually, when I did the interview, I did the background behind me. I came out of a trailer, and I did the trailer park thing, and Kayla's like, Dad, really? It's Vlad. He's the CEO. He has more money than you'll ever make. I'm like, yeah, well, until his company gets delisted. Hey, where's that sell button anyways for GameStop? I always told my kids, you reap what you sow, right? So anyways, looks like a Robinhood's going to have an earnings call. What you guys going to do? You going to exit? I mean, at $9, whatever, you've lost everything. How are you guys on the, have you? You actually have a lot lower to go. But I say, whatevs, you guys do you. Some of you are like, oh, I'm not going to exit prior. It's just too much risk for me. I don't know what you have in store. Behind door number one, you have $1 million. Behind door number two, you lose both of your arms. And behind door number three, you have large amounts of credit card debt. Oh, okay. Good news is I know what's behind door number one. Then they're like, but now we close the door and we mix them up. Now try to pick. So that is why I exit prior to earnings, because I don't know. It's just too much risk for me. And if you lose your arms, you won't be able to like this video, which I'm asking you to do, or subscribe so I can see you tomorrow. And I will see you tomorrow.